In your earlier talks, when you started doing this series, you focused a lot on an academic appreciation of Hinduism, or an academic and intellectual approach towards Hinduism, which I think really does appeal to the younger generation. And lately, you've kind of veered off again into talking more about personalities of the historical period in question. And my question is, whilst both are relevant, is there a way to link the two? So is there a personality or a particular story that can really represent philosophical ideas well, in your opinion?
And there'll be no intellectual way I can bridge this gap between the relative and the absolute. There will always be a gray area. So we continue, in a way, to try and touch both these areas. We like put our foot in both the camps by talking of the absolute principles and then again relativizing it through, if you like, personalities. It's a constant struggle. And there is no easy peasy answer to this. It is a gray area. And every individual will try and somehow bridge this gap in his own unique manner. And that's what I continue to do, that I struggle. And so did Vivekananda. This is a struggle. How do you relate this absolute idea, pristine and pure, this very relative, mundane world? How do we link this two without falling into the trap of personalizing or giving too much importance to the personality? Let me give you an example. This Vivekananda set up a monastery in the Himalayas at a place called Mayavati. And this monastery was meant to talk about spirituality in an absolute manner. No need for any forms, names, gods, no room for God there. He said, this is going to be a place suited. It's called Advaita Ashram. Only the idea of Advaita, this high principle-oriented religion, is going to be promoted there. And nothing else is going to get in there. So they set up the ashram in the Himalayas called Advaita Ashram. And then Vivekananda visited it. And he went there and he saw a little room. They said, this is a shrine room. In the shrine room, they found the picture of the old man, Ramakrishna, sitting there. He said, throw him out. I'm not joking. He said, throw him out. How did he get in? Didn't I tell you this is a place where only the principle of spiritual is going to be invoked? No personality is getting in, including this old man. Kick him out. You see, he can talk like that about his master. And the master must be telling, yeah, go on. So it is this kind of constant struggle between the absolute and the relative, between this idea of personalized religion and an abstract, principle-oriented religion. It's a constant struggle.